You'll recall that when we looked at the integration strategies, I said, basically, it all comes down to one of two ideas. Either it's going to be substitution or by parts. So let's have a look at this idea of by parts. Now, when is it useful? When we've got a product of two functions. Okay. So you could think of it like the product rule for integration. In fact, sometimes people call it the reverse product rule. Here's the formula that I use. Integral of u to v is equal to uv minus the integral of v to u. Let me prove it. Okay. If I was going to differentiate uv with respect to x, so u and v are both functions of x, then I'd use my product rule, write down the first, u, diff the second to v dx, plus write down the second, v, differentiate the first, du dx. So that's our product rule. Well, if I was to integrate both sides, so uv would be the integral of u to v dx times dx plus the integral of v. Well, the dx is cancelled. Bang, I've got my formula. Then I rearrange it, I should say, before I get my formula. So integral of u to v is uv minus integral of v to u. Now, the choice of u and v becomes important. How to do it? U. Well, if you look at my formula, u needs to be something that I can differentiate. Because in my formula, I'll end up with a du. Ideally, it would make that function simpler. Dv then needs to be something I can integrate. So that's basically what I'm looking for. So integral of x times sine x. One of those things will be u, one of those things will be dv. So my working out on the right, how I tend to do it, is I'll say, well, okay, I'm gonna choose u to be x, because when I differentiate x, I get 1, that's a lot simpler. Whereas if I differentiated sine x, I'd get cos x, that's pretty much the same thing. So du will become dx. Dv, I've chosen to be sine x then, and I can integrate sine x, it's minus cos x. So putting that all together, u times v, so x times minus cos x, minus the integral of v du, but minus minus becomes a plus. And so now all I have to integrate is cos x. And we know the integral of cos x is sine x. Integral of log x, remember I said I tend to just memorize this one as x log x minus x? Well, let's actually go and prove that now. You might look and say, well, hang on, that's only one function there. We said we were gonna use it when we got two functions multiplied together. Well, the other function I'm seeing there is simply the number one. So u, at this stage, log x I can't integrate. Therefore, I'm gonna choose it to be the thing I'm gonna differentiate. So du becomes dx on x. So dv is simply dx. Integrate one, we get x. So now I can put it together. Uv, x log x, minus the integral of v du, minus the integral of dx, integrate dx, and there's the x log x minus x. That's what I was expecting. Okay, let's do a definite one. So xe to the minus 7x. I'll choose u to be x, so du is dx. Dv is e to the minus 7x. Integrate that, I'll get minus a 7th e to the minus 7x. So uv, but now I've got limits I have to include. So from 0 to 1, minus minus becomes plus, a 7th e to the minus 7x. Now, whether you want to work out the first bit now or leave it until you've done all the integration, it's really your choice when you want to do that. So I've left it all to the end. And so when I integrate the e to the minus 7x, I get minus 1 on 49. E to the minus 7x, substitute in 1, substitute in 0, and we get an answer. Ah, the classic one, e to the x cos x dx. Okay, remember what we said, we want to choose u so it makes it simpler. So if I choose e to the x, differentiate e to the x, I get e to the x. Well, that's not really simpler, it's the same thing. If I choose cos x, differentiate cos x, I get minus sine x. Again, not really simpler. All right, maybe it's the other condition. Something I can integrate, e to the x. Well, I can integrate that, it's e to the x. Cos x, I can integrate that, it's sine x. So in this case, it really doesn't matter. So which way did I go? I went u is equal to e to the x, du becomes e to the x dx, dv cos x, so v becomes sine x. So we get uv, so e to the x sine x, minus the integral of e to the x sine x, and I pretty much got the same problem that I started with. So I'll do it again. But whichever way you chose first time, stick with it the second time, or you'll end up in a nice circular argument and you'll come back to where you started from. So I'm once again going to choose u equals e to the power of x. Du then is e to the x. Dv this time is sine x. So v will be minus cos x. Okay. So it's going to be minus uv. So minus minus becomes plus e to the x cos x minus 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 the integral of e to the x cos. Oh, I'm back to where I started. But now, this is where I look at it, and I don't think of it as steps of working out. I think of it like it's an equation. And I'm saying the first line equals the third line. So I'll now move that integral to the left-hand side, and I get two lots of the integral of e to the x cos x dx is e to the x sine x plus e to the x cos x. So now I'll divide by two, and we have our answer. Feels like we haven't done any integrating, but we have, of course. We did it over here in the working out on the right-hand side. So we did do some integrating there. 4f, let's have a go at playing with integration by parts.